not been well, and she's not able to be with us. She usually heads up our shepherd group. I'm going to ask for all the shepherd leaders to come up front, if you would. And I left my list in the office. You got yours. Let me go get it.
I want to say a little bit about homecoming next week. All of your leaders will be calling you, and if they haven't contacted you already, for what to bring. Now, next Sunday, this is a family day, so bring stuff like you're going to feed a family, okay? And lots of it, and we're going to have fun. You got your list.
These are our shepherd leaders, and they are here to help us very much. How many has heard sometime people will leave a church, maybe dissatisfied, and or maybe they've been gone 4 or 5 weeks, and nobody ever got a hold of me? How many's heard that before? I bet everybody in the room has. And that's what we want to try to prevent, okay? And to do that, we have to work together as a body to do this. And that's why I have these leaders to help me. Because sometimes I'm in a service, I got my mind on one thing, and that's what the Lord wants to do. You know what I'm saying? That's me as a pastor. So it's hard sometimes. I'll see faces, but I also will sometimes miss faces. Amen? You understand what I'm saying? I'm one, there's many. All right, so it's difficult, and we don't want to miss anybody. We want to love each and every one, because that's what it's about, you know, and we don't want anything to happen. So I've got shepherds now that takes groups in the church. We've set up in smaller groups so we can kind of be aware of who's here and who isn't, and somebody's missed a couple weeks, and we can make a call, make sure everything's going all right, if they're doing okay, or, you know, whatever, and just to make sure everything's going good, or if they need prayer and things are really serious, then they'll let me be aware of it so that I can get in touch with that person. Amen? And when it's really done right, it really can work if everybody does everything right. And so we wanted today to introduce our shepherd, and as we introduce each leader, we're also going to mention your name, who you're under, and what we'd like for you to do when I call off the first shepherd person's name, the couple, when they stand, I'm going to read their list, and then I'm going to ask when I read their list if you're here today to stand so they can see you as well. Okay, we're going to get a better identification today. We just wanted to take some time to do this because we felt it's important. We've been growing, we're getting new people, and I do want to mention this so I don't forget it. If there's anybody new here that's been coming and you're coming regularly and you're going to be here and you're not on this list, we want to get you on this list. All right? It's very important to us so we can stay connected. How many knows God wants us to stay connected? Amen. Amen. Absolutely. So this is a big deal. It really is. We as shepherd leaders try to meet at least twice a year as leaders to just see how things are going and check on things. Or there's anybody new that needs to be on the list, and we don't want to miss anybody. So, and Becky does a wonderful job. She really does. She puts a lot of work in this. Yes, she does. And she needs our prayers as well. She's not physically been well and going through some things. She's got an appointment the 27th, and we need to continue to lift her up in our prayers too. But I'm going to start this now so we can get it moving. And the first one I want to mention is Dave and Mary Bolton, okay? And Dave, Mary, would you? Yeah. And I want to read who's on their list. When I read your name, just stand real briefly till I call all the names, and then you can sit back down. We'll get the next one, all right? This is Dave and Mary Bolton's. We have Don Baratas and her family, okay? We have Wilma Barrick. We have Jessica Boatman, okay? We have Jane and Eli Boatman. We have Sharon Boltman, Linda Calloway, Melissa Chandler, and I know she's absent today too, Kim and Alexis Long, okay, Michael and Robin Riley, and Betty Topper. Okay, those are the ones we're marrying. I just wanted to get a look. All right, you may be seated. It's good. Thank you so much. Appreciate this. Okay, the next one, if I can get the pages turned here. Okay, we got Dale and Trudy Fouts. Okay, and this is who's on their list. We have Anita Branch, and I don't, there she is. Good to see you, Anita. Bless you, hon. Eugene, Viola Down. We have Jerry and Darlene Elliott, not here today. Okay. Michelle Glasper, not here either. Okay. Mike and Tina Hopkins. Rick and Diane Jackson. And Steve and Sandy Madden. I think they're going to Michigan too this weekend. All right. Thank you so much for standing. You can see those. And Herb and Mittie Faust. Herb and Mittie on this, okay. We have David and Juanita Buffin. Is David and Juanita here today? Paige Cross. We have Jean Sue Frazier. Jimmy and Don Hancock. Joe and Tammy McLaren. Okay. Gary and Shirley Smith. Not here either. And Rick and Patty Steele. Rick's here and Patty's in the back running the sound. All right, thank you so much, guys. Okay, we now have a new shepherd on our list leading, and that's Frank and Peggy Hawk. Okay, they're down here on the end. And amen. I'm glad to have them. We have Janet Ford. Okay. We have Kathy and Tanner Gibson. Jennifer, and is that Arwen Weber? All right, yes. Okay, and Ramona Williams. Ramona here. Okay. Thank you, you guys. Thank you so much. Okay, AC and Jan Hill. Right there. All right. Okay, we have Selma Bliss. Selma not here today. Tony and Rhonda Brew. Beverly Clear. Beverly Clear. John and Linda Miller. Sick today too, okay. Lisa Miller, the back, running the screen for us. Kayla, is that Scully? And Teresa Williams. Okay, thank you very much, all right. Okay, then we have Dixie Jordan. And on her list, we have Christine Brady. Leroy and Peggy Carroll. Let's see. Terry Gamblin. Diana Myers. Diana Myers here. Lorraine Moore. Diane Patterson. John Patterson. Rocky and Diane Tryon. Willavon Tooley. All right, thank you very much. Next leaders is Jerry and Sue Castle. Sue Castle, huh? Yes, yeah, he's in the hallway out there doing our sheriff duty today. All right, shepherd, sheriff, Jerry's a No. So you better behave, he might arrest you, you know? He's a retired policeman, he knows how to do that stuff. All right. Pam and Ray Aldridge, and they've been gone quite a while. They're doing a camp thing down in near Pendleton. So, okay, Matthew, Rhonda Barenberg, and the children. Yes. Hannah and Elizabeth. Yes. All right. Todd Bogue, Dottie Stewart. Okay. Don and Linda Flynn. Who did they? Okay. Dan Fortner. He's in the foyer too. Okay. Gleason. Patty Julius. Okay. Dan and Neva Lawson. Dennis and Vicki Phillips. Sandra Rowe. And Amber Canals. Jason Colbert. Okay. Thank you very much. All right, the next one is Jerry and Sandra Kuhn. We just got them back last night late. They were on a cruise. Going to Irma. No. They got out of there. Irma wasn't too nice, so they decided to come home. No. But they were actually on a cruise and got put back to New Orleans and was able to fly in last night. And good to have them back safe. And continue to pray for their children, too. Some of them are still out there, so lift that up. Okay, their list, Fanny Bass, Valois Brown, Tanita Kuhn, of course she's at home, and Wayne Loretta Majors, Phyllis Pearson, let's see Phyllis today either, Cherry and Nedra Price, Keith and Gay Schrader, I see him this morning either, and Pat Schrader. And then, of course, we always, Braden Lawson, and he has the one and only Albert Swain, because they winter together down there, and hopefully they got somewhere to go this winter. I don't know. They may be staying in Indiana. I don't know what's going to happen, but when they winter down there. So Braden, that's the only one he really takes on his list now, being gone 6 months. So I had to mention that. Dad's gone today. He's going to be playing down in southern Indiana this week, so he'll be back a couple weeks from now. So, all right, the Miller, Bill and Stephanie Miller. Tom Roberta Bowden, Eldon Cass, I'm not here today. Mandy Cox, Abby Henning, and Kevin Henning, Bill and Wilma Tyler, Mike and Tama Zell, and their son Elijah. Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Then I have Rick and Becky Satterwhite. Becky's sick, but there's Rick there. And they have Vita and Alan and Tanner Sturch. Lori Armstrong. Let's see her. Wanda Burchett. Bruce and Anita Talk. Amanda, is that Ebo? Ebo, is that right? Okay. Charlotte Feller, Kirby and Karen Hall, Tyler and Courtney Howe, Joe and Holly Hollinger. Got my tongue kind of twisted. Charlene Nirin. Carlene Nirin. Sorry about that, Carlene. Judy Russell. Okay, thank you. Thank you, guys. If you're here. Okay, the other shepherds are Steve and Jenny Hsu, and they're not here today. They're in Michigan today. But their list is Jim and Jenny Branson, Dave and Lori Burton, Leland Burton, Paul and Mary Enix, Don and Betty Fredrickson, Brenda Height, Dean Heather Schimmelfenning, and Jordan Stephanie Wilson, children. And I think Jordan's in the, Stephanie's behind us, okay.
I'm in Leland's group?
Yeah, you are. You know what that means, don't you? Pray. All right. Don and Nola Sims, next leaders. Don and Nola right here. All right. Sheila Grant. Russell and Loretta Jarrett. Jack Mognett. Jeff and Laura Sims. Seen Jeff back here and Laura, yes. And Tom and Carol White. All right, thank you very much. The other one I have is Ralph and Darlene Strict. And Sharon Klum and Nick Weishart. Carol Cupp. Garfield, Danny Judkins. Mike Pickett. Frank and Loretta Quinn, here today. James Smith, he's back there in the back of the camera. Norma Wheeler. And Linda White. Thank you so much, thank you. I have now Larry and Clarinette Wilson. Wow. That was good. Larry's got a, Clarinette's got a fan base, isn't he? All right. Donna Collins. Everett Cottingham. Everett's here. Stand up, Everett. Dave and Shirley Heffemeyer. Ruth Hostetler. Scott and Vicki Moore. Ben and Connie Powie. And Ben is officially retired. Yeah. Vicki Pavey. And I have John Chelsea Rhodes. They're in Children's Church, okay. Very good. All right. Last one I have is Vicki Wilson. Vicki here? Okay, I couldn't see her. Guys had her head. Yeah, there you go, Vicki. All right. She has Kenny Bennett, and Kenny's always works in the morning, so he's here on Sunday evenings. Dennis, Gail Boren. She's back here, Gail. Standing, yeah. Already standing, right, Bill? Well, you're tall back there. I didn't think this is, I can't believe this is as much fun, you know? Jack and Beverly Foster. Jack and Beverly here. DR Surface. Don't see DR this morning. Dave and Karen Sturr. It's Dave. Yes. Tom and Debbie White. See him back here. and Susan Zoli. I don't see them here today and their parents. All right. Okay, that is our list. And as you can see, we got a pretty good crowd here today. But did you notice how many that wasn't here today? Can you imagine if we get the majority of that here, what we've got? Amen? We've got a, and ones that's not here will be here. Some are here, you know, that some things, you know, they miss a Sunday, they're here another Sunday. So as the things pull together, you can see our crowd is really picking up. And we had quite a few names gone today. So things are happening, okay? Now, what I want to say is this. If you're here today and you're coming steady, we want you to get with us. Get with me. Get with Sue Castle in the end here. Becky's gone. And let us know, or Sheila, my wife, because we want to get you on a list, okay? We do. We want to make sure that we can cover everybody and do it right and keep informed with everybody. Okay, yes.
Usually when they use the card.
Yes.
When you use that card, we know if you're here three times, you'll get assigned to one of these that will get in contact with you. Fellowship, loving fellowship. Another one is through fellowship with one another, like that over a phone, if we sense that you're in need or going to the hospital or something like that, you get prayed for. The pastor will get information. We have deacons, five of us, six of us, that'll go out and visitation on Wednesday, and you'll be on our list, or so of us stop by and see how you're doing. Maybe give you uplifting of the situation you're in too. That is a fellowship that we pass on the love of the Lord. Amen. So we appreciate that.
Thank you, Rick. Yeah. 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 If there's a special need, or if there's something, you know, and we're not aware of it, you're going to have surgery or some special need, feel free to call the shepherd leaders too. It's not just them calling you, but if there's something going that way, we can connect. Because you connect with that shepherd leader, they can connect with the pastor. We can all be in this together and get information, because it's very important that we communicate. Okay, that's the purpose of all this. We're connecting together so we can communicate, keep in touch, amen, and pull this thing together. And that's why the connection cards are so important. Because even new people, when they fill it out week after week, Becky senses that. She sees that name, it's new. Then she wants to get them connected on a shepherd. You know, phone numbers, all that is good. And like we said, if there's any changes, be sure to circle that. If you're coming all the time and you've got a new address or new phone number, be sure to write that in and circle it. You know, and circle it too, so we know, hey, that's somebody's here all the time, but they've got something changed. It's new, okay? All right. All right, these are your shepherds. Yeah. If you're a visitor for the first time, we want you to fill out the whole thing, the connection card, and then hold on to it. And at the end of the service, go back to our welcome center as you leave, and they'll have a guest packet for you, and they'll take your card, okay? But if you're here all the time, you can throw that into the offering bags when we get ready to take up our offering, which we're about to do here in just a little bit, okay? All right. These are your shepherds. Will you pray for them, will you? As you pray for me, yes. And I appreciate it. You may go back and the seats, and you know, and we're always looking, you know, as time grows, then we're always looking for other leaders that can help us. And we try to keep these lists very small, so there's not a lot of names on each one that leads. So we can keep it small so we can focus on those individuals. So I'm sorry we took that time, but we really needed to do that as the church is growing. We really needed to do that. So at this time, I believe we're going to have Garfield to come, and he's going to share a word with us. If you want to stand again, everybody now can stand. Garfield's going to share a word with us and lead us in prayer as we get our hearts now more prepared for worship. And right after Garfield gets done sharing, we'll have our ushers to come, and we'll take up our morning offering, ushers, as soon as Garfield is done here.
Okay, praise the Lord. You know, I thought this was great. I was able to put some names and faces together today. You know, that's one of my problems. You know, I hear about it and I say, I don't know who that is, and yet I do. So when I see you, now maybe I'll remember your name, but don't bank on it. That's one of the funny things that happens when you reach a certain stage. I haven't got old yet, but I can't remember names like I used to. So if I ask you again your name, it isn't that I've forgotten you, I've just forgotten your name. Praise God. All right, this morning I want to share something from Nehemiah as they came and they built the wall. And when the wall was finished, this is the praise that they brought. Stand up and bless the Lord your God forever and ever. And blessed be the his glorious name, which is exalted above all blessing and praise. Thou, even thou art Lord alone. Thou hast made heaven, the heaven of heavens, with all their host, the earth, and all things that are therein, the seas, and all that is therein. And thou preservest them all, and the host of heaven worshipeth thee. That's a lot to praise God for. In my study, when I get up early in the morning to pray, about early in the morning, 5:30, 6 o'clock, and when the moon is out, when it's a full moon, I see it at night before I go to bed. It's over in the eastern sky. But in the morning, about 5:30, 6 o'clock, it shines right in on me. You know, just a bright shaft of light. The heavens certainly declare the glory of God. I just get feeling, looking up into the sky, and just awesomely worship Him. He made all those things. He made the heaven, the seas. What the seas are doing today, He made the seas. And when we pray, we'll pray today for those in desperate need. But let me say this, and I won't include it in my prayer, but to say that, well, God, why are you doing? Our country is long overdue for the judgment of God, long overdue. We have insulted God in every way possible, but His mercy endureth forever. It's by His mercies that we're not consumed already. And when we see these things this year, it seems like more than previously. You know, some of us have lived long enough to know that things are changing. And the storms, the fires, the violence, it just all seems to be coming to a head like a terrible boil on the body, you know? What's happening? I believe with all my heart that God is saying, wake up, wake up. Wake up. And really, it's the children of God who know the Word of God, those of us that know Him, He's waking us up. Because the rest of the world, they're blind. And the only way they're going to know what's happening is when we tell them. But we should be the ones that are saying, God, You are doing something. Now, we see all these people that, there's a lot of Christians that had to deal with Harvey. A lot of Christians that are dealing with Irma. And we got Jose coming along too. And you say, what's going on here? But what about those Christians? They're hurting. And we say, well, God, He said, look, I never promised you that I would take away all tribulation and distressing circumstances, but I did say I will be with you. The Lord knows them that are His. We are all going to face these kind of situations. Just because we're living in Indiana, everything else passes us by except a tornado now and then. But remember, even Christians are going to have a hard time of it as the Lord gets His bride ready for His coming for them. Because He's coming for a bride without spot and without blemish. And boy, the church really needs a cleaning up. Listen, folks, to what's going on. Join me as we pray together. Father, as we come to You this morning, we do praise You, Lord. We trust Your character. Your character is perfect. You do all things well. And Father, You never bring destruction. You never bring great testing upon us unless we need it. And Lord, and when You do, it's not, You even control it. You make the wrath of men to praise You, and the remainder of wrath You restrain. So Father, we pray especially this morning for those Christians that are going through such tribulation and testing right now. Many of them losing everything that they own. But Lord, You did say, once more will I shake all things, in order that the things that cannot be shaken will remain. Father, we need to be shaken down to what is really real in our lives, and we come and see that's You. You are the rock of our salvation. And Lord, You've said that You will never leave us nor forsake us. You know those that are Yours. Father, we thank you for that. And Father, we pray for those that are in just deep distress today. And Father, I pray that you'll give them peace. Father, maybe some of them have needed this to say, Lord, I've placed too much emphasis upon this life and the things of this life. Lord, thank you for what you're doing. We praise you. And Lord, you will only do what is necessary to be done. And Father, we thank you. You have not forgotten us even here. Lord, you're working mightily. And Lord, it's not going to be an easy road. But Lord, we know that the Lord knoweth those that are his. And he says, let everyone that knoweth him depart from iniquity and lawlessness. So Father, we surrender to you this morning. We say, thy kingdom come and thy will be done in us, Father, because we know what lies ahead. Our Lord is coming soon. Thank you for the word of God that gives us this insight and understanding. I pray, Lord, that you'll help us in this fellowship here. We want in his image to be a reflection of the Lord Jesus Christ, so that people driving by and people that visit will not see us, they'll not see our church and our buildings. Thank you for them, Father. But we want them to see you. We want them to see Jesus. And so, as we pray this morning, we ask for a real blessing of God upon us, opening our eyes of understanding. Lord, as the word comes forth, may we hear it with the depth in the depths of our heart. For Father, we need you desperately. We need the Holy Spirit desperately to awaken us and help us to understand what your word is telling us. Father, we commit this service to you now. We commit ourselves to you now. And we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your love. And we trust you, Lord. And we trust you, the character of God, which is holy, holy, holy. We ask these things in the name of our Lord Jesus. And Father, we worship you with a prayer that he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Ushers, would you come? As the ushers are coming, I want to share that the shepherds probably will be getting a hold of each and every one this next week for what you'll be bringing for the homecoming dinner. We always like to split that up so we have a balance of everything. We'll have a great meal here next Sunday right after our homecoming service on Sunday morning. And like I said, we keep keeping that list. And as the people fill out, we always put new people on the list or back on the list. Some's been back on the list. We'll be back on the list. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, God, again, thank you for this day. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to be in your house. Lord, we welcome you continually in this place. Lord, we've come to worship you this morning. And Lord, we come to lift you up in spirit and truth. Bless this offering, Lord. Bless each and every one that can give unto you, Lord, as you have blessed us. And Lord, we ask you to continue to be with those in Texas, and we ask you to be with those in Florida right now. Some could not get out, Lord, they had to stay. So God, we ask for your protection upon them, Lord, as this goes through. And Lord, we're asking Irma to flee, God, to the depths of the sea, out in the, where we're not even hit near what they thought. And Jose that's following, Lord. Lord God, we ask you to move it, Lord God. Move it in the name and authority of Jesus. And God, we just thank you, we praise you, we give you glory and honor for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. Amen.
One, two, ready, go.
Before we start, Vicki, do you have something you want to share? Amen. As we continue to worship here this morning, I'm going to ask my leaders to come at this time, and we want to take some time for prayer. And as Heather leads us in this worship song, we'll have our leaders to come. And if you need prayer, whatever you need, maybe come. If you need to be anointed, they're here to anoint you, pray for you. Come on, leaders, come on up as we pray this morning. Just open your hearts to the Lord. We're here to stand.
Thank you. I know for a fact. for God to break, and for you to say, my problem is too big, my pain is too deep, my sickness is too far gone in my body. You're basically saying that God doesn't have the power to do for you what he said he would do. I'm here to tell you, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It covers it all. There is no lie that he can't heal, and he can't make truth, that he can't write. There's no wrong he can't write in your life. And I'm imploring you to listen to these ministers today that have said that the Holy Spirit has talked to them and said, I have a message. I have a blessing here at this altar. I encourage you to listen. Come, if you ever come, today is the day.
When I got new glasses, I could see better because my perspective changed. And the change we often imagine around our body, right, binding us up physically. Many of us have changed around our minds. And Paul told Timothy that he gave us a spirit of sound mind. Mind without chains. And of power. Of the divine power that raised Jesus from the dead. And of love, unconditional, self-sacrificing love. Some of us need the perspective change, like Dale was saying, about Satan. Satan is a created being by the Creator. We are created beings by the Creator. The difference is this. We were the only ones created in His image. That means we were created above Satan.
Jesus, there is power.
just sense something coming.
Yeah.
They sense it, Irma. We sense the Holy Spirit today.
Amen.
Greater is He that's in us than He that's in this world.
Yes.
You know, in just a little bit here before we leave, we're going to take communion with the Lord's Supper. And folks, we have victory.
Amen.
When I look at this and I look at the bread and the wine, what it represents for us, Jesus, He spoke, He said, "This is my body." Amen. When He blessed and gave it to them, His body was given for us. It was ordered, patterned, ripped to pieces. Stuck the stripes on His back for you and me. He just didn't do it for punishment. He did for you. Are you in the room today?
Amen.
I said He just didn't do the punishment. He did it all for you.
Amen.
Every stripe was born on your behalf.
Amen.
For your sickness, for your diseases. He carried it all. He still carries it. He still takes it. That's what the purpose of the cross was. He completed the work for you and me. He did it all. He accomplished it. You know, it's more than a man just hanging on a tree. He accomplished the work. He defeated the Satan, the devil. Put Him in His place. So you and I can walk with Jesus and put Him in His place. Are you here today? Praise be to God for what He's done. His blood was shed for the forgiveness of our sins. They're no longer covered, they're taken away. That's powerful. When I take this morning, I'm reminded of my healing and my forgiveness. And that my sins have been cast in the depths of the sea, far as the east and the west, because see, the east and the west, there is no ending. And He cast it as far as east and west, never to be remembered. Never! Never! That means nobody else needs to bring it up.
That's right.
Especially the house of God. If you are, you need to be praying because this is the fourth time. God has come to heal us, touch us, to make us new. There's rededication. People have come back to the fold. Isn't that wonderful?
Amen. Walk away. You're
going to
see me wearing this
today. Forgiveness of our sins, never to be remembered anymore. They're gone.
You can't do this in closure.
Praise be to God.
When He's up there.
All what He did is beyond what we even ask or think or comprehend. But I know this, it's wonderful.
I'll get better though.
And I'm reminded when I take this strength of who He is. He is my God. He's a God that loves me and cares for me, He's forgiven me, sanctified me, and is coming to get me again.
Yes.
Amen.
He's coming back. Amen. He's a God that never leaves you nor forsake you. He's accomplished it. He's did everything He needs to do for you and me today. And that's what makes us so precious. He did it. He took my punishment. He took my sin. He even took upon my sins. I know some people have a hard time with that. Well, it's the will of God. It is the will of God. He completed it. You mean you don't believe you'll ever die? Yeah, I'll die in this physical death, this body. But as far as with Him, I'll never die. This body can't go, but the rest of you is.
Yeah.
My soul and spirit's going with Him. My new body, glorified body. Yes, that's what He has prepared. That's what the devil will tell you. The blessed assurance He is mine. And so wonderful name of Jesus, there's power.
Yes.
In his wonderful name.
Yes.
I ask the deacons to come. We're going to begin to move in this direction.
Thank you.
saved my life.
Yeah.
Yes, the blood. It is. It is. Each and every one of us is victory in the Lord today. Amen. If you're saved, you know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Yep.
You know what this song is talking about, and you're truly saved today.
Yes.
And know Jesus. What a blessing. Man, I'll tell you what. Isn't it great to be this house? Man, I knew the wave was coming this morning. Just wait on him. He did it. You know, it doesn't matter what type of service you do when God comes, he comes.
Yeah.
There's no magic wand for this thing. It's just about his Holy Spirit that moves inside his people and draws people to him in a heavenly way. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Aren't you glad he's on the throne?
Amen.
He's still working today. Working on us. Praise God. Praise his holy name. I ask Frederick Miller if he would to bless us. Granted us once.
Your grace, Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear Lord, for this opportunity, Father, to represent the Father that you shed for us in the cross.
Yes, Lord.
The ribbons and lashings that you took, Father, for us. And the blood that you shed, Father, for us today. Thank you, dear Lord, that represents the Father, the one who is the best.
As they were eating Jesus, he took the bread and he blessed it and he broke it and he gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. Took the cup, gave thanks and gave it to them saying, drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which was shed for many for the remissions of sins. And then he said, I say unto you, I will not drink this fruit of the vine from now on until I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. What a day that's going to be.
Amen.
Amen. When they had sung a hymn now and then all. Just remind you, 4 o'clock, the choir. And 5:15, the worship team will practice. Then at 6 o'clock, we'll be back to worship again and see. Amen. Before each and everyone's coming. And I'll just sing a little bit more of that song here. Just go out quietly and just thank the Lord. Amen. God bless each and every one of you today. Be blessed. Thank you.